So this week's episode of Fruits Basket only now have two episodes left before the first season wraps up and we await the second season. This week was rather interesting. It functioned in a very wholesome, but also sort of disturbing, potentially disturbing depending on where the secret goes, but also just really sweet episode overall. And we even get introduced to a new character who, based on the reaction of Kyo, seemingly would, at least my guess would be, the master that he trained with, because it wasn't a look of distrust. It kind of looked, he was flustered, he was in awe, so I think it's someone he definitely likes. So I'm going to be interested to see where that's going to go over the last two episodes, because really, when he was looking at him in the rain when they were walking away, Kyo smiled and he looked rather shocked. So I think, I don't know if it's going to go potentially dark with just their individual interaction, but I think it's going to be fun to see that relationship play out for the short time we get to spend with it with the remainder of the first season. But the first half being dedicated to a sick Toru was very wholesomely entertaining, is how I'd put it. Because this is a girl who literally is freaked out anytime someone has a common cold because of what's happened to her in her life. However, when she's sick, she just completely ignores herself, which is totally in character for Toru, someone who really thinks she has no self-worth. She completely disregards her own feeling and well-being for the benefit of others. I have to go into work, I have to make money, I have to cook people their dinner. She doesn't even comprehend that even if it's a basic illness, if you take care of it now, it won't cause you longer issues in the future. And to just see where this went, I thought the relationship between Kyo and Toru in the sequence was incredibly adorable. Something I've talked about before is how the relationship between her and Kyo and Yuki and Toru are really different, and I really like just how natural the Kyo and Toru stuff is, because really, Kyo, he's someone who tries to push back. He tries to make himself feel like a villain, make sure that people don't latch onto him. You can really see that with the dialogue with Kagura. But I like how even in this situation, he knows what he has to do. He has to cook her food, make sure she doesn't have any reason to get out of bed, and make sure she rests and doesn't hurt herself. And just that entire sequence between them just sitting in a room, it was some of the most interesting dialogue that honestly has been presented in Fruits Basket over the past month or so. The reason I liked it so much was just them sitting at a table as she ate, and he just says the simplest and but honestly most important lines to her. If you have to rant, just tell me what you need to rant about. He doesn't overtalk, he doesn't step over, he lets her say everything that she needs to say before he voices his opinion. A lot of the time, people in general, myself included, we try to talk over people when we hear something that just seems ridiculous. Like, she's overreacting about a test, she's overreacting about all these things, and you would naturally want to say, you're being insane, you're a silly girl, you don't need to do this. But what he naturally did is the most important and just really highlights how good they connect right now. He let her talk. He didn't say anything. He let her say everything she needed to, and then he voiced why she was being stupid. He's saying like, oh, Yuki, who cares? Let the guy die. It's a simple test, you'll make it up. Work, don't worry about it. The idea of your promise to your mother will get better because otherwise everyone's going to worry. Just the way he naturally, he still feels like Kyo, he still feels like that hot-headed Kyo, but his natural words and the way he interacted with her in the sequence is some of the most just natural connection that you can point out to within this season of Fruits Basket. It just feels like two people who naturally understand one another, understand the emotions, and even though Kyo clearly has a secret that he's hiding from Toru, it naturally feels like the current relationship they have is something that naturally connects, and it doesn't come across as forced or anything like that. It just feels wholesomely perfect, and I absolutely eat all that up. There's some great comedy in the first half as well. I love when she was failing her test, and then you see her friends, and just the idea of Saki being like, I failed everything, and so nonchalantly recognizing that it's just not a big deal, even though everyone's like, you just failed everything. But the whole idea that she failed on purpose just to see what the makeup test would be like, I just love the simple moments and just the overreaction. So then even when Kagura comes over and just, I swear, it's something I keep forgetting how much I love, but when he slams doors in her face and just what she'll do, punching through, open the damn door, and just seeing poor Shigure just looking at the damage that it's causing, I love it. I love just how all these personalities connect, because we're not always going to see characters like Kagura. We're not always going to see all of the Somas, but when we mix and match the cast overall, just seeing the banter and ridiculous shenanigans that can occur because of the current cast formation is simply wonderful. We've seen Shigure have to repair his house so much that he's now come to the conclusion that if this happens, I'm just gonna make them go out on a date because screw this shit. I'm not, even if I take money from their accounts, we're not dealing with this anymore. This is too much to bear. And I really like that because this episode, it really is just a combination of like 90% of this episode is really highlighting what this season has built up to with the current cast as seen here. That we can just put these characters alone in a room together or just natural dialogue, and because we understand when they're, you know, threatening to kill one another, we're not taking it seriously anymore. We're not thinking like they're actually going to hurt each other. They have this interesting connection, and I just love how all the personalities are bouncing off one another and just where the future of the series could go. Not only just with the new character we get introduced to, but just the idea of this secret. I don't know if it will get a kind of confirmation of what the secret is by the end of the season, by the end of the series. Eventually we'll get it for sure. I mean, eventually we'll learn about the hat even more as well. There's tons of stuff to learn and explore with, but it's going to be interesting to see not only how this secret connects to Toru and why he's trying to keep it away from her, either just making himself look bad or if it actually does connect to her, but the idea that Kagura is also a part of it apparently. I just feel like everyone, or at least a good amount of people, are keeping something a secret from others because they truly feel like, should they expose this secret, the current connection they have with Toru will be thrown out the window. And whether that would be the case or not remains to be seen until the cat's out of the bag. And I think that's what's super interesting, is how, even though we have all these zodiacs and this like supernatural curse, the idea of withholding information because you're scared it will sever the current connection you have is one of the most like painfully relatable things ever. Even if it's a little white lie, sometimes you feel like if we expose this, everything will be ruined. And sometimes you do have a dark and horrible secret that in the past, maybe you did do something that's horrible, but will that ruin what you have currently because of the current action, the current, say, Kyo or Toru or anyone right now? Like, who you are in the present to me matters a lot more than who you were in the past, as long as you've clearly evolved and changed. Really, there's so many ways that people can learn and grow, and I don't know exactly what the secret's gonna be, but that's kind of the fun thing, is kind of pondering and thinking about what it could connect to, but it's going to be fun nonetheless, and just seeing all the sweet shots, romantic shots. I just love how this series presents itself, because it can be romantic, it can be like, what am I looking at, and why are the character models acting like this, but it is hilarious and really matches Toru's mentality, or any of the characters' mentality so perfectly at this point in time. I really just feel like Fruits Basket has really evolved over the 23 episodes. When you really compare, just like, even though the overall style, presentation, interacting has remained consistent throughout 23 episodes, it feels to me that, you know, the longer we watch the series, the more confident this storytelling just feels. It started off amazing, but it just feels like it finds new ways to present the ideas and themes that it's aiming for, to make it feel like a classic shoujo, make it feel like a classic series that you would expect from the past, seeing a lot of the character designs and overreactions and even just some of the dialogue. But when you really break down how the characters are reacting and seeing how they're being presented, from simple smiles that may go unnoticed to the little blushings and just the overall mannerisms that these characters either have, from their body language to their overall voice acting, it really feels like this feels like human nature. And if you can feel like human nature as you look at characters who, if they're hugged by the opposite sex, will turn into, say, a cat, I think you're doing something right. There's a way to take the supernatural and just not really connecting to normal reality, and allow a series to really elevate and become something that is so gripping that you can still compare it to. There's a series I love called Interviews with Monster Girls. It's a series that you would think would be just a harem, a Monster Girl harem, but what it actually is, it's a character study series that uses Monster Girls as a way to explore some pretty serious topics such as racism and all the other nasty business within the modern reality. And I love that Fruits Basket can do the same thing with the idea that it has the supernatural zodiac curses, but it just applies them to this really interesting story that has so much darkness and corruption, but also a lot of hope and optimistic natures that it can go down. And that's why I think everyone falls in love with this series, or I should say most people fall in love with this series, because when you see the story presented correctly, you really see what the Fruits Basket is at the end of the day. And to me, it's a character drama and character study series that really just with every episode, whether we're looking at slice of life, like for half this episode kind of was just, you know, the daily life of sick Toru, to the more complex nature of a hidden secret and just a new character who might shake up current Kyo and what he's currently feeling. It really just feels like Fruits Basket has this formula that it's kind of sad that not many took influence in terms of modern anime and modern mangas and light novels, because this is really an exceptional strong series that I wish more would copy and paste what Fruits Basket did, rather than the shallowness that we see copy and pasted season after season. And you can kind of just throw a dart at a wall and you can kind of hit one of those shallow series that I'm talking about. But Fruits Basket is far from shallow. It's a goddamn masterpiece at this point in time. It's really interesting though, because certain anime will try to do this thing where they shift up the style quite a bit through an episode. You see it a lot with comedy series, and Fruits Basket has its fair share of comedy. But I feel like the way they can shift around from like super serious close-ups to romantic tension to just absolute absurdity, it's something that I think it really blends well with the characters' personalities. And I think the reason the shifts in style with both the art, the directing, and even the animation design at times, the reason it works so well is because the characters' personalities are all so varied and wild, and because you have characters that are so multi-layered such as Toru or even Kyo, the shifts in style, they never come across as jarring, they come across as just like natural. Like if we really were to view these characters and kind of match the perspective and just mentalities at hand, this is what it should look like. Obviously it's anime, it's drawings, but if we were to apply the real world to this, if we could really get inside the heads of some of these characters, the natural shifts between scenes and styles, it just feels so perfect, and not a lot of anime can say that. But what did everyone think of this week's episode? Favorite moment, where you think next week is going to go for anime originals like myself, let me know. Be sure to like the video if you did enjoy, and also hit that subscribe button if you happen to be new. So until next time everyone, please take care and have a good one.